So, good morning all. This is M. Suresh, lecturer in Computer Engineering, Government Polytechnic, Masaptank. In the today's class, I will discuss what is this Android activity lifecycle. Every activity, whenever you are seeing your screen, that single screen is your activity. So, whenever I am interacting with one single activity, so how much flow it will, what are the different phases it will go? That is the activity lifecycle. We will see that in detail. And the next one is one of the important component of Android, that is your intent, which has main many purposes. We will see that in detail. In the previous class, I have already discussed what is the use of toast message and how to write toast message to give some notifications to the user. And in the today's class, I will discuss what is this Android activity lifecycle. So, in the Android activity lifecycle, okay, one of the fundamental building block of Android app development. So, Android activity lifecycle. So, it is one of the fundamental building block of Android application development is activity. So, whenever you want to develop, actually many components are there. So, in the Android app development, we have four important components. So, what are those four important components? So, whenever you want to develop this Android application, then we require four important components. Yeah. So, what are those components? So, whenever you want to develop this Android application, there are four important components. Those are your activity. The first one is your activity. And the second one is your service, and the third one is your broadcast receiver, okay, content provider, and the last one is broadcast receiver. Okay, so these four are the important components. So these are the four components: activity, services, content providers, and broadcast receivers. So, what are the four important components? I think I will go to this notepad. So, whenever you want to develop this Android application, there are four important components. That is your activities and services. Next, content providers, and the last one is broadcast receiver. So I will give in brief introduction to each one. The first one is your activity. Activity is nothing but whatever the single screen that you are seeing, right? So whenever you are seeing this screen, whatever the screen that you are seeing, this is your activity. So for each activity, we have two files. That is your .xml file and another is your .java file. So this is your activity. Activity is nothing but whatever you are seeing on the developing any mobile application, compulsory it contains a lot of activities will be there. So whatever the screen that you are seeing, that is your activity. And services. Services are nothing but these are the background processes that are running, which will provide some service to the applications. Okay, like whenever you are on switch on this Wi-Fi, it does not contain any user interface. If you see this activity does not definitely contains this user interface. So it has some screen, and if I am developing an application for the calculator, compulsory this has text box, and I should have some buttons. So I can have buttons like this. Okay. So this is this user interface, how it should be visible to the user. So that is your activity. So whatever the screen that you are seeing and what are the UI elements that are there, it may contain tabs, everything. It may contain rating bar, everything. So all those UI components I will put on a single screen. Then this is your activity. But services are nothing but whenever you are developing this, these are the background services. The user cannot interact with these services. Activity, the user can interact because he can click on this button so that some action will be done. Everything I will write in the .java file. and how the component should be visible to the user, that I will write in the layout.xml file. But in the services, services are nothing but these are the background processes that are running in the background without user interaction. Like if I switch on this Wi-Fi, the best example is switch on Wi-Fi. Whenever I switch on this Wi-Fi, so yeah, automatically it will detect the Wi-Fi networks that are available in that particular location and it will show that one. And later, if I go to the new location also, even if you turn on this Wi-Fi, background it will be running. It will, based on the location, particular location, it will automatically search those networks available in that particular location and it will show. Okay. So that is about your Wi-Fi services. And after that, one minute. Yeah, so it is. One more thing is, so this is about services. So and one more best example is like I can play the music. Okay, I can open Jio 7 app or any other mobile power amp, okay, any other MP3 player, and after opening that particular music I will play, and even I can do some other works, like I can open my WhatsApp and I can listen to the music, right? So that this music file is running at the background. So that is your services. So there is a service for this power amp app or Jio 7 app which will makes the songs to be running at the background, so that I can play forward or anything I can do. At the same time I can do some other tasks. That is the services. Services are nothing but these are the background process that will be running at the background without the user interaction. And content providers, so which are used to provide the data to the other applications. Okay, so for example, if I take WhatsApp, okay, the best example for this content provider is WhatsApp. So whenever I open this WhatsApp, automatically I will get all the contacts who are having this WhatsApp from this contacts app. I think if you open this phone, you have separate apps for this contacts. Contacts is a separate app. So whenever you open this WhatsApp and you go to this WhatsApp contacts, automatically whenever you refresh that one, whoever the persons that are having this contacts, whoever the persons that are having WhatsApp account, only those person details will be shown on the WhatsApp app. So this is separate WhatsApp app. And this context is separate app. So whenever one application wants to get the contents or data, okay, from another application, that is provided by using this content providers. This is also one of the important component of Android, which will provide the data that is required by one application from the another application. That is your content provider. But this context app should have the content provider, okay, whatever the data that I am storing, like always contacts app contain name, phone number, email, okay, everything that will be stored on the local database. That is your SQLite database. We will see, I will explain this SQLite database in the coming classes. So the database that I can use for the mobile apps to store this data is your SQLite database. So whatever the data, whenever I am adding the contact, then I will write the name of this contact and what are the mail ID of the contact, what is the company and what is the mobile number, everything those will be internally stored on the database. Okay, once those data will be stored on this database, it will automatically create a content provider, so that this content provider will be shared, so that this content provider, it automatically creates a content provider. Okay, it automatically creates this content provider. 1 minute. So this 1 minute, I have to check. So this automatically creates this content provider. So we have already seen about this activity. Okay, so in case of activities, So the screen, whatever the screen that you are seeing about and every app, that is your activity, and services are nothing but background process that will be running for your application. Okay, for any application, I can create the services. These will be running at the background, which will do some task. And content providers are used to provide the data of one application to another application. And the broadcast receivers, which are giving some system announcements, like when the battery is low, then it will give a indication like the battery is low. And whenever I connect the charger to your phone, then it will give this notification like charging is going on. And whenever I connect the headset, then it will show this kind of system announcement like this is connected. Okay, this will be connected. So these kind of system announcements can be done by using these broadcast receivers. So all these are the four important components of Android. One is your activity, which is nothing but your screen that you are seeing on the mobile app. So every single screen that you are seeing is called activity. We can have any number of activities, but one of the activity can be acting as a main activity. Okay, one in which one of the activity is your main activity that will be launched whenever you open that particular app. Whenever I click on that particular app, whatever the first screen that you are coming, right, that is your main activity. If you want to make it as main activity, then I have to define in the Android manifest.xml file. And in case of services, these are running at the background. Okay, which will I already explained the example like Wi-Fi. So whenever I switch on this Wi-Fi, automatically some processes will be running at the background, which will be finding out what are the nearby Wi-Fi connections available. Okay, and also you can run the music files at the background, and you can do some other tasks. So that is your music file. Music app contains this services, which will makes the app to run at the background so that it can play music. Content providers are best example like WhatsApp is getting the data from the context. If one application wants to get the data from the another application, that is possible through these content providers. And broadcast receivers are used to give some system announcements. Whenever our application wants to directly communicate with your Android operating system, then those kind of announcements can be possible by using these broadcast receivers. Okay, whenever battery is low, then it will give some notification, alarms, and whenever this reminders I set those also. And whenever I connect this charger, automatically you will get this charging is going on. And whenever I connect this headset, automatically you will get this kind of notification. Okay, all these announcements can be done by using this broadcast receivers. So in this, I am discussing about the first component, that is your activity lifecycle. So one of the fundamental building of Android application development, okay, is activity. Without activity, I cannot create any application. It is just like a single screen with the user interface. Activity is the main entry point of an Android application, just like main method. Okay, it is like a main method for your program. If you are writing C, C++ or Java program, compulsory main method should be there, right? In the same manner, activity is the main entry point for any Android application. An activity interacts with the user, so it creates a window to place UI elements. Okay, always activity is created so that it will create like a window so that you can easily place your UI elements. If I want to create a app for the age calculator, then I will take one date field which will take the date so that I can have one button. So if I have calculator button, then just click on calculator so that automatically based on this date it will have the logic to calculate the age. Android application can contain several activities, means many different screens that can interact with the each other. So, and the next one is your activity life cycle. So every activity has its own life cycle. So whenever I am discussing about this Android activity, every activity has a life cycle. If you take a single screen, single activity, each activity will go through some different phases. Okay, we'll see that. During its life cycle of an Android app, activities are stored and managed in the stack called activity stack. Okay, new activity comes on the top of the stack and becomes running. So if you have one activity, so when I click on this calculate, automatically another activity comes. Or when you have this, it is like whenever I open this one, if I click on this one, then automatically you will get this screen, right? So I click on this message. So whenever I click this messaging, whatever the first screen that you are seeing, right, that is your whatever the screen that you are seeing visible at the first time, that is your main activity. And in this, if I click on this one, okay, if I click on this home page, automatically this activity is not visible, right? So that some other activity is coming, that is your home page activity, okay? Yeah, so like this, all these will be, so it is nothing but the first activity is your messaging app, just now I opened, and after that I opened this home activity, so that first home will come and message will be at the background. Again, if I want to get this one, just you can click here, automatically you will have this messaging activity over here, right? This is like a stack. So if I click on messaging, again this will activity will come. If I click on back, then again some other activity, okay, like this. If I click on phone, so this is your phone activity, okay, phone activity, the first main activity is just you are getting a this kind of interface. This is your tabs, three tabs are there, okay. This is your first tab is having this dial pad, and the second one is your call log activity, and third one is your no contacts. So this is your contacts activity. So again, if I click on this back button, automatically it is coming, okay. So like this, this is getting the icon, okay, or some other. So but again you can go to this phone activity, okay. So that is your while previous remains below the new activity in stack. When the tap activity is in the stack exists, the lower on the top becomes active, okay. So whenever this one, whenever I click on back, and if I am again going to this one, then this activity will be coming. So what are the different states of an activity? So every activity will go into the four states, okay. So that is running. So whenever an activity is open, so this is nothing but activity is now running. It is running or active state means. So it is running or active state means it is at the foreground of the screen. Now you can say this phone dial activity. This is your phone dial activity which is at the foreground of the screen. And passed, an activity which is alive but not focused is the passed, okay. So when I can say this is your phone dial activity, for example this is your phone dial activity, so it is now running. But whenever I click on back, now it is not at a closed, it is still alive, because if you go to this one, it is still alive but it is not focused, so this is your passed, okay, passed state. And resumed, when the passed activity becomes active, means nothing but whenever I click on this one again, then again it will come into the resumed, okay. And stopped means nothing but whenever I click on this, whenever I click on this entire, it I will move, I will delete that one, then I cannot see that phone activity, right? So that is your stopped activity. An activity which is no longer visible on the screen is the stopped activity. So again I will show with example. So what is this one? Yeah, if I open this app, so like this, I will open a messaging app. So now the messaging in this, I can have the name of this one, like message show, okay. I can have here compose. So if I click on compose, automatically one compose screen will come with for which you want to send and what is the message that I want to enter. When I click on this back button, automatically that new message is not there. Okay, that is in the passed state. And again, if I want to, yeah, so if I click on this one, okay, so now this messaging is not there. If it is not running, it is passed. Now again, if I want to resume that one, just click on this one, again it will come. But if I completely delete this one, so it is no longer available, that is your stopped state, okay. So these are the four states. And the main callback methods that are there in the Android activity lifecycle, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, total 6 methods are there. So I think in the previous example, I have shown only onCreate method. Whenever you open any Android app, okay, so whenever you open any Android app, 1 minute, it is taking some time. So when I open any app, okay, So in the previous class I have shown this method, right? UnCreate method. So whenever we have main activity, it will always extend this app compact activity, and in that we have this UnCreate method, in which we have the first statement super.uncreate, and the second one is your set content view, which is used to show the layout file. Okay, only we have seen this active UnCreate method. Most commonly for any activity, we will definitely override this UnCreate method. Like UnCreate method, we have some other methods also, that is UnStart method, UnResume, but we don't concentrate or we don't use override these different methods, but we will definitely override UnCreate method, which is used to show the layout file on the screen. So now we will see the different methods. Okay, what are the different lifecycle, Android lifecycle methods? So the first one is your UnCreate method. This is the first callback method. So this is your first callback method of an Android activity. It is called whenever the activity is created. So whenever the activity is created, this UnCreate method will be called by default. So by default, this method is overridden by the Android app. If you create a single activity, compulsory this method has to be overridden, which will be called when the activity is created. This is where all you set stuffs like button and views. Okay, by using this UnCreate only, you will write everything related to what should be shown to the visible, what should be visible to the user. Everything I will write in this UnCreate method. And the next one is your UnStart method. It is the second callback. It is called when the activity is visible on the screen. Okay, first UnCreate method is called. After that, UnStart will be called when the activity is visible on the screen. And the next one is UnResume. This is called after UnStart if the activity comes to foreground. As we are writing only UnCreate method, that's why you cannot observe this one. But so if you showing a single activity, I have to call these three methods. Okay, that is your first UnCreate will, I will show with example. Okay, so the first UnCreate method will be called, and after that UnStart will be called, and the next one is UnResume. So for showing a single activity, these three methods will be called one by one. First UnCreate is called, and after that UnStart will be called, and the next one is UnResume is called. UnPause. So this is followed by UnResume. This is called when a previous activity is resumed. So whenever an activity is resumed, that is whenever an activity is losing the focus, then this UnPause will be called. And next, UnStop. It is called when another activity is resumed, then this activity is no longer visible. UnDestroy. This is the final callback when the activity is finished. If you see that entire thing in the diagram manner, I will show with the diagram. So first one is activity started. So for starting this activity, I have to call these three methods. So that is UnCreate, UnStart, UnResume. So what is the meaning of this one? So whenever one activity, when I click on the app icon, automatically this screen is coming, right? First, getting this screen, these three methods has to be called. UnCreate first, UnStart, and the next one is your UnResume. Once these three methods are called, then I can say my screen or my activity is running on the foreground. Now, if any new activity is started, if I click on another activity, then automatically previous activity will go to UnPause. Okay, UnPause. Again, if your activity again comes this foreground, again it will call this UnResume method. Okay, but other application needs memory, then this process is killed. And again, if the process is no longer available, then that is your UnStop method will be called. Again UnStop, again your activity comes to foreground, then UnRestart method will be called, and again UnStart, UnResume, like this. But if it is once closed, then UnDestroy method will be called and the activity is shut down. So once this activity is shut down, then this activity is no longer available. Okay, so we will see this entire thing with an example program, then you will understand. So but whenever we have a single activity, this activity goes through total seven methods. What are those methods? Is UnCreate, UnStart, UnResume, UnPause, UnRestart also there. This is UnRestart, UnStop, and UnDestroy. So total seven callbacks are there. So whenever I am, this is the default method. compulsory you have to write this onCreate method, which is the first method will be called whenever the activity is created. Okay, onStart method. So, but whenever I am showing a activities to the user, the means that we are first calling this onCreate method, onStart method, and onResume method. Once these three methods are called one by one, then I can say this activity is running. Okay, now if any other activity comes in between, then this previous activity is going to this onPass, and after that after some time it will go to this onStop. Okay, first onPass, and after some time it will go to this onStop method. Okay, once again if it is calling again that activity, it is not in dead state, but again I can call, right? So at that time it will go to this onRestart again, and again onStart and onResume, these three. Okay, so once again, but whenever this activity is no longer available, then it will call this onStop and onDestroy, so that the activity is shut up. So I will show with one example program. 1 minute. So whenever I can show with the example. Okay, so whenever simple terms, so whenever a screen is visible, then onCreate, onStart, onResume will be called. Whenever another screen comes in between, then automatically onPass will be called, and after some time onStop is called. Again, if I call this previous screen, automatically onRestart will be called, and onStart and onResume. But if you completely remove this activity, then automatically onPass, onStop and onDestroy will be called. We will see this with the example program. So I think I will open this activity program. So in this activity, so this is your activity main.xml file. So if you want to create a new project, then go to this file and click on new project. But I already opened this activity_main.xml file. So first of all, I will open this activity_main.xml file, which will does not contain anything. So just it has a single screen. Okay, you can see here a single screen is there. If you go to this code, inside this code, you have just a simple linear layout I took, and inside this one we have a text view. In this text view, I have given only the activity lifecycle. Okay, this is your activity lifecycle, and it has the text color and text size, and it is bold. Okay, so this is just a simple. Okay, this is your activity lifecycle. One single screen is there with this activity lifecycle is the text view, and in the main activity, okay, I have written all this. Okay, so this is your what is the name of the package, and this is the app compact activity. This is by default you will get, and util I took this util.star. This is the util package, and if you know about Java, then you know about this util package. And I am extending this app compact activity, and I am taking a string tag. So there is a log file. So all the log files you can see over here, log cat. So generally I will use in between what is happening over here, that if I want to see in the Android application, then I will use this log.i files. So which is nothing but which will give some information to the user. For this one, I have to give this tag for searching that, because in the logcat, if you open this logcat, so it will contain all the messages. Okay, so whenever I am running this app, automatically in between what is happening, what is the flow of that execution, everything I can see in the logcat. So for this one, first this onCreate method is there. So this is for this onCreate. In the previous class also you have seen this onCreate method. The first one is calling the super class onCreate method and set content view to this activity_main dot xml file. Okay, so for this one, for every if you want to see this logcat, so what is happening over here, so for seeing this one, because as I didn't started this emulator, so 1 minute. So if I open this one, this is your onCreate method in which I have created this log data type. So you can see that log messages in the log cat. Okay, this is your log cat. You can see this all the whether how it is executing. I can see over in the log cat message. So for this log data type, which is nothing but you have this all these type of different messages like debug messages, info messages, warning messages, error messages. I will create log data I, which is nothing but info messages. What is the tag for this one is lifecycle, so that I can easily search this lifecycle over here. So now actually this log, if you open this log.cat, so it will show everything. So whenever I launched this app, everything that it will have some messages. But if I want to filter that one with this lifecycle, I am creating a tag. So that this log.I will take two things. One is your tag. Tag is nothing but to filter because it may contain many number of messages. So whenever you start opening this emulator, from that one whatever execution, every message will be recorded in the log.logcat file. So that if I want to filter with this lifecycle, I will use this lifecycle, so that I will get only the messages related to this lifecycle. So in the onCreate, total 7 methods are there. So first one is your onCreate method. So in the onCreate method, I am in the log.i file, I written as I am in onCreate method. In the same manner, I have onStart method, so that I am calling the superclass onStart method, and log.i file with I am in onStart method. And the next one is onResume method, and the next one is onPass method, and next onStop method, onDestroy method, onRestart method. Total 7 methods are there, right? So for each method, what I am writing, just I am calling the superclass method, and after that I am writing in the log.i. I am in onStart method, I am in onCreate method, I am in resume method, I am in pass method, and I am in stop method, I am in destroy method, okay? So that I will see the life cycle. So just this is a simple program. In the activity main.xml file, I created a activity life cycle, that's it, okay? This is the text view. I created a linear layout in which we have this text view. And in the main activity.java file, I have written all the methods, all the different callback methods. So for every activity, it has to go through these callback methods. So that is, this is the life cycle. So whenever the screen is showing means that is nothing but it will call this onCreate. Okay. If you open this one, whenever one screen is visible to the user. So whenever one screen is visible to the user, what is the meaning of that one? It will call this on, first it will call this onCreate method, onStart, and onResume. And in between, if any other screen comes, means onPass method, and sometimes after some time it will go to onStop. But if it is completely deleted, means onPass, onStop, onTestroy. But after onStop, if again that screen is visible, means that is onRestart. So we will see with the practical example. So what I will do is I will run this program. For running this program, first app, I have to select this as app. And I have to select the Android virtual device, as I have already created this MineXS. Just click on this run app. So it will take some time. Okay. As the Gradle is build is running, it will take some time. In that time, I will pause the video. So you can see over here. So now the Gradle build is finished. You can see all the logcat messages. So for each second or milliseconds, it is giving some messages. So now as it is running, it is becoming slow. Now you can see, so all these messages are running. So Gradle build finished in 5 minutes. And now it will be, yeah, so all the messages are showing. You can see all the messages. So after this Gradle build is finished, it will start the installation. Okay, it start the installation in the app, and the installation successfully finished. Okay, so now you can see here I won't require all these messages, right? Because I am interested in the only what are the life cycle, Android activity life cycle messages, right? So for this one, it is tracking, just wait. Yeah, you can see here. Okay, so this installation successfully finished in 15 seconds. Okay, now and you, if you open this app, so this app is running successfully, right? Activate life cycle. So first, but I want to see which methods are called whenever this for showing this screen. So what are the methods that are called? So for seeing that one, okay. So first of all, I have to call this life cycle. So if I have this life cycle, so I will search only this life cycle over here, that is like life cycle. Okay, if I click on this life cycle, I think some mistake happened, just wait. So you can see here, so this installation was successful, installation successfully finished. So if I open this one, so as I can use this one, okay. So if I open this one app, so first I will it will automatically launch actually. So otherwise I will open this and I will click on this and activity life cycle. So whenever I click on this on activity life cycle, so you can see here, so first one is whenever that screen is launched for the first time, okay, so it will be calling this on create method, and after that on start method will be called and on resume will be called. So whenever I am passing that one, then so this is for the first time, first time whenever that screen is launched, it will show these three methods. So for the first time, whenever that app is shown to the user, then after clicking on this run app, then automatically whenever the first time that screen is shown, right, this is related to activity. So whenever that first screen is shown, it will first call, okay, first it will call this onCreate method, after that it will call onStart method, and it will call this onResume. So that whenever my screen is visible to the user means activity is running means it is calling these three methods. So you can see over here. So you can observe over here. So this is your. So for the first time, whenever you are calling screen is shown to the user, then it is calling this onCreate, onStart, and onResume method. So now what I will do is I will open another screen. I will click on this back button or I will open home screen. So what is the meaning of this one? Losing this, the screen is losing the focus and another screen is coming in front. So if I click on this one, then you can see here. So first, what it is calling? On pass it is calling, and after that on pass, on stop. You can observe over here. So whenever another activity is coming, then it will call on pass and after that sometime on stop. Now again what I will do is again I will open this activity life cycle. So now what is the meaning of that one? Then again it will call this on start and on restart, after that on start and on resume. So you can observe over here. So first I am for the first time whenever calling is on create, on start and on resume, and after that whenever that screen loses focus, then on pass, on stop. Again that screen getting means that is on restart is called first, next on start and on resume. Now what I will do is I will completely destroy the screen. Okay, so I will again back button. Back button means nothing but on pass, on stop, on destroy. Even if I call this entirely this again, if I open this one again, then that is as it is destroyed. Okay, again it will call on create, on start, and on resume. Back button also it will feeling like on destroy only. It is destroyed only. But for the first time, whenever I calling this one, on create, on start, on resume, and whenever it loses the focus, then first on pause will be called, and after that on stop. And again, if it is coming back, again if it is getting the focus, means on restart and on start and on resume. If you see here, again it is getting the focus, means on restart first, next on start, on resume. Now if I completely whenever if this screen I completely, okay, so what I will do is on pause, on stop. But whenever I click this, completely remove this one, okay, and on destroy only it will be calling. Okay, so that is the life cycle of Android application. So whenever actually, but we don't write all these methods, but every activity will contain though total 7 methods which should be overridden. So but mostly we will use this onCreate method, which is called only for the first time whenever I want to show the screen to the user. So whenever for the first time that app is visible to the user, means that is nothing but onCreate method is called, onStart is called, and onResume is calling. Okay, so if you see the entire life cycle, I can use this flowchart. Okay, whenever that screen is visible to the user, means onCreate, onStart, onResume. And if the screen loses the focus, means that is nothing but on pause and on stop. Again, if gains the focus, means on restart, on start, on resume. But if it is completely, that activity is not at all visible to the user, means on destroy. Okay, on pause, on stop, on destroy. So this is the activity life cycle. Okay, this is about the activity life cycle. Instead of this log.i, you can use the toast message also for displaying the activity life cycle. You can use toast.make_text. Okay, I am in onCreate method, get application context, or I am in onCreate method. Like that also you can write for showing this messages. Okay, so this log.i, why I am using is, but just for showing these messages in the logcat, so that you can understand what is the flow of this activity. Okay, so whenever activity is running, means it will call this onCreate, onStart, and onResume. And whenever activity loses the focus, it calls onPause and onStop. But whenever and again if I restart it, it again gains the focus, means on restart, and after that on start and on resume. But if it is completely lost the focus, or if it is completely not available, means on pause, on stop, on destroy. So whenever I click on this button, like whenever I click on this activity life cycle, so if you see this one activity life cycle, whenever I call this one, so for the first time means on create, on start, on resume. But whenever I call this, it loses the focus, means on pause, on stop. And again, whenever again I call, means that is nothing but on restart, on start, on resume. But whenever it destroys, then automatically first on pause, and after that on stop, on destroy method. Okay, this is the activity life cycle. Hope you understand the activity life cycle of a Android activity, or say single application activity life cycle. Okay, so actually I thought of explaining this intent also, but as the time is over, then in the today's class I discussed what is activity life cycle. So even if you have any another activity also, it will also have this flow cycle. But generally every program I will use only one single onCreate method. The main remaining are all just you want to know the activity life cycle. How the activity will be going from whenever that activity is started until it ended, ending its activity. What is the flow? For showing that flow only, we are using all these 7 methods. But we will use only this onCreate method, which is used to create the activity, and which is used to show the activity to the user. But internally, these all will be executing. Okay. Even for the second activity is there also, second activity also, it will flow through this one, everything. But mostly we will use this onCreate method only. Okay. In the next class, I will discuss one important concept, that is your intent. There are two types of intents, explicit intents and implicit intents. Hope you understand today's class. Thank you. Thank you all.